Question 30, Electrical Engineering, Gate 2017 Set 2. In the circuit shown in the figure below, the value of C required for maximum power to be transferred to the load is dash. Four options are given to us. For a basic concept on the maximum power transfer theorem, please refer the NPTEL video, Module 1, Lecture 10, Thevenin and Norton Theorem in Equivalent Circuits by Dr. Nagendra Krishnapura, IIT Madras. We'll just have a look at this theorem and see how to apply this for this problem. Maximum power transfer theorem states that a resistive load being connected to a DC network receives maximum power when the load resistance is equal to the internal resistance, also known as Thevenin's equivalent resistance, of the source network as seen from the load terminals. Consider this Thevenin equivalent network. The Thevenin impedance is, let us say, RTH, and the Thevenin voltage is VTH. This is connected to a load of unknown impedance. For maximum power to be transferred to this load, this impedance must be equal to the source impedance or the Thevenin equivalent impedance. In this particular example, this is a purely resistive network. Therefore, the load's resistance must be equal to the source resistance. Or, in other words, we can say that the load's resistance should be equal to the source resistance and the reactance of the load is equal to zero. This is the concept that we are going to apply for this problem. Here, it is given that the source's internal resistance is 0.5 ohm. So, we must ensure that the load resistance is equal to 0.5 ohm and the reactance of this load should be 0. The effective impedance of the load is given by the impedance contributed by the 5 mH inductor plus a parallel combination of this resistor 1 ohm in parallel with the capacitive reactance XC. So, ZL is equal to J omega into 5 mH plus 1 parallel with 1 divided by J omega into the capacitance which we need to find. So, from the question, we can infer that the value of the angular frequency is 100 and hence we can substitute the values over here. So, ZL is given by 0.5J plus 1 parallel with 1 divided by 100CJ, which is given by 0.5J plus 1 by 100CJ divided by 100CJ plus 1 divided by 100CJ, which is equal to 0.5J plus 1 divided by 1 plus 100CJ. So, when we simplify the second part of this, we can get, which is equal to 0.5J plus 5000 C square J plus 1 minus 100CJ whole divided by 1 plus 10000 C square. So, this should be equal to 0.5 ohm, which is the internal resistance of the source. Therefore, the real part of this term should be equal to 0.5, which is 1 by 1 plus 10,000 C square. So, this implies that the value of C square should be 1 divided by 0.5 minus 1 whole divided by 10 to the power of 4, which is equal to 10 millifarad. So, for maximum power to be transferred, the value of this capacitance should be 10 millifarad. And hence, the answer is option D, 10 millifarad. Thank you.